I was that kind of man, just a skinny one. I don't dance, but here I am, spinning you round and round in circles. It ain't my style, but I don't. You got me in the palm of your hand, 'cause I don't dance. Love's never come my way. I've never been this far, 'cause you took these two left feet. It ain't my style, but I don't.
As we celebrate the union of these two lives and we witness them become one flesh in this covenant before our Heavenly Father. Christian, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together after Yahweh's holy ordinances in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her and keep her, in sickness and in health, forsaking all other women. Keep yourself only unto her as long as you both shall live. Mariah, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together after Yahweh's holy ordinances? In the holy state of matrimony, will you love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him? In sickness and in health, forsaking all other men, keep yourself only unto him as long as you both shall live. A covenant relationship is not to be entered into lightly or without great forethought. This is a holy and sacred covenant designed by our Creator to be honored until death, defined by our Creator as the union between one man and one woman. You're pledging to one another that all that you have and all that you are now belongs to your covenant partner. You're making a promise to each other that from this day forward, you're committing yourselves to your partner's well-being. You're dedicating yourselves to do everything within your ability to make sure that each other's needs are met. And you're making a vow to each other that you will honor this covenant until you take your last breath on this earth. Christian, my charge to you today is this: love Mariah, protect her, lay down your life for her. Make sure that she feels the security of your love for her daily. Never leave any room for doubt in your relationship. Take the time to stop everything that you are doing. Look into her eyes and connect with her heart. King Solomon, in his great wisdom, said this in Ecclesiastes chapter 12 and verse 13. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God, keep his commandments, for this is man's all. This is the greatest wisdom that anyone can give you, Christian. Fear God, keep his commandments, and he will see you through, and you will flourish as a husband, and you'll flourish as a father. And when it's all said and done, you will have succeeded where many before you have failed. As his wife, you have great power. And by that I mean you have the ability to create a champion out of Christian. If he feels your love and your confidence in him, he will achieve greatness in this life, and he will go further than you or he ever thought that he could. If you will invest in each other's happiness, you will find this marriage and this marriage covenant to be the greatest blessing in your life. Christian, would you repeat after me? I, Christian, take you, Mariah.
I, Christian, take you, Mariah.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Mariah, would you please repeat after me? I, Mariah, take you, Christian.
I, Mariah, take you, Christian.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or poorer. In sickness and in health,
in sickness and health,
to love and to cherish,
to love and cherish,
till death do us part. I hold in my hand a wine glass that no one has ever partaken of, and as a symbol, every covenant is sealed with a covenant partaking of wine and food. So in this moment, this couple is going to drink from this glass as a symbol of the covenant that they are entering into. When it is finished, Christian is going to break this glass, and no one will ever be able to partake from this covenant cup ever again. Let's pray. Father in heaven, as we stand before you now in a holy fear and reverence for who you are, this couple that stands beneath this chuppah, so we pray right now that you would seal this covenant, that you would put a hedge of protection around this couple, that you, as you have promised in Psalm 91, that you would give your angels charge over them to keep them and to protect them. Father, we pray for favor upon their lives, that you have promised that if they would walk in your commandments, that every blessing that you have given to your people would come upon them, yea, it would overtake them. We pray for blessing and favor to overtake this new family. We bless you. And I bless this family from Numbers chapter 6, the Aaronic blessing. Yevorechacha, Yahweh, Vishmarecha, Yair, Yahweh, Panavelecha, Vihunecha, Yisa Yahweh, Panav lecha, Visem lecha, Shalom. Yahweh will bless you and keep you. Yahweh will make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. Yahweh will lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. May your lives be sealed by the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit of God. And may you flourish in this covenant you have entered into. We pray these things in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus, the Mighty One of Israel. Amen. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen. Those whom Yahweh hath joined together, let no man put asunder. By the power vested in me as a minister of the gospel of Yeshua, our Messiah, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Christian, you may kiss your bride. Christian and Mariah Ingram.
My brother told me that I was going to be the best man. I mean, I kind of seen it coming, but I was really honored for him to choose me for it and to see this beautiful moment for my brother and his bride was really touching. And for them to see and hang out with my brother and grow up with my brother and just see all the focal points of his life change from when we lived in Texas, and we didn't really connect with Jesus that much. And to see the man that he's become now is absolutely life-changing, and he's kind of like my role model, I guess you would say, because I kind of look up to him. And first, for one, I want to thank him. Thank you for allowing me to be your best man. But thank you, Mariah, for putting up with me. But mutual. But I love y'all. I'm so happy for y'all. And for the many, many years to come, I pray that Yahweh will bless y'all mightily. 12 months, I'll have a nephew.
I'm not really good at this, but I wanted to say a few things, and I'm really, really thankful that the time that we bonded, the nights that we cried together and shared our insecurities and what scared us, it really, really, really helped me, and you're an amazing friend. And I'm so happy that he finally got Christian. And I'm glad that he realized how special you were. And sorry, are. Special you are. But you're an amazing person, and I'm so thankful to have you, and he is so lucky to have you. And I wish you and pray that you have a wonderful marriage that I know that you will have. And yeah, congratulations.
Mariah and Christian. I cannot be more proud of you than I am today. Christian, you have an amazing young woman. Take good care of my baby. And she will do you good all the days of your life. I have not been the perfect wife. I have not been the best mother. But I believe that I have shown her how to stick in there when times get tough, how to fight for her family, and how to love. It might not feel touchy-feely all the time, but sometimes that's not what you need. So, Mariah, I love you. I'm proud of you. Do him good. Be an example. Be a light together. And I just pray that Yah blesses you, that your marriage is long-lasting, full of love, full of laughter, a lot of laughter. Just remember that you are loved greatly by everyone in here, and that we genuinely want the best for you. I love y'all.
So I want to second the gratitude that Ashley shared. Couldn't ask for a better body of believers and family that God has brought us here for. You know, I know for us, when the Father spoke to my husband and I and told us that we were to move to Tennessee, it wasn't an easy decision to make, and it was hard for the boys and so forth. And Christian originally didn't even know for sure if he was going to come. But I thank God that his plans are greater than our plans, and his ways are bigger than our ways. And he led him here. And not only did he lead him here, he's blessed him here abundantly. He's drawn him closer into his covenant with him. And then now he's blessed him with a beautiful, beautiful bride. And I just wanted to say to you, Mariah, when he was a little boy, he looked up at me and he told me, he said, "Mama, I want to marry you when I get old."
and so he can't do that, but I'm thankful that he gets you. I'm thankful that he gets you. And so, and I know the Father has brought you into his life, and I know that he has ordained this marriage, and that he has put his hand upon each of you, and I'm so very thankful for you. I'm thankful that you get to be my daughter in love. And I know that you will love him, and I know that you will cherish him, and you will encourage him, and I know that he will adore you, and he will lift you up, and he will lavish his love upon you, and take good care of you, and provide for you, and fight for you, and with you, and every other ways, and that's going to be good. It's really going to be good, and I'm very thankful for that. And son, I love you so. You make me so very proud. You make me so very proud. You're such an amazing young man. I love your heart. I love your spirit. And I know that both of you have overcome many challenges in your lives, and the rest is going to be just great. It's going to be great. There's going to be ups and there's going to be downs, because that's life and that's reality, but it's going to be good. It's going to be good. And I know as you stick together with Yah being in the center of everything, that he's going to carry you through in every way. And I pray God's blessings over each of you, and I thank you, and I love you.
One more. I'm going to make this quick. Mariah, I'm honored.
Dang it.
I'm grateful that God gave me the opportunity to be a father figure in your life. I know we've missed out on some things. I love you, and I will always be here for you. You are the light of my life. You're my little girl, and I know that you're in good hands. I just want to make sure you knew this. I love you so much.
So I just wanted to share that and just let you know that wine is actually symbolic. If you take any type of food and you mix it with itself, if you take apples, mix them with apples, you know, you get apple juice, oranges, lemons, those types of things. And when you take those separate foods, somebody's calling me. You take those separate foods and you put them together, you know, they each have a value of itself, but when you put them together, the value really doesn't change that much, except for one exception, it's grapes. So if you can think about, you know, the cost of a cluster of grapes versus a bottle of expensive wine, you know, you can see that the value raises exponentially. Yeah. And it's the same thing, you know, with marriage. Sorry, I'm a little nervous. But so when this wedding's over and you put your box back in the dress and everybody goes back home,
dress back. What did I miss? Let me drink some of this for a second.
Thank you. Hey, that's better. But really, when it's over, you know, there's an important crossroad that you got to make. You know, y'all be standing there. You know, y'all can actually come together, and y'all can bring y'all's grapevines close together. I mean, you could share, you know, the house, finances, children. You can even share the bed, but you can still remain apart. You can still remain apart. Or you can choose to combine. It's a much harder path. You know, you can give yourself to each other, give up your own desires for that of the marriage, right? You can crush your grapes together. Y'all can become one. And that's how God designed, that's how he designed it from the beginning. You know, in Genesis, it states, you know, that a man shall leave his father and his mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Not really close, not any of that, but one flesh. And that's what y'all need to be. Y'all need to be one flesh. You need to crush your grapes together and become like wine. be like wine. Cheers.
Of kisses to make it all complete, and that's the recipe for making love. And if you've made it right, you'll know it. It's not like anything you've made before. And if you've made it wrong, you'll know it, 'cause it won't keep you coming back for more. I didn't get it from my grandma's book up on the shelf.
And a chance, she loves me like Jesus does. I'm a long gone wailing song on violin.